The HTC Desire C is a cost-effective way of getting the latest version of Android and HTC Sense, though when we reviewed it we thought it was underpowered. The Samsung Galaxy Ace2, in contrast, has ample oomph, but it runs an out-of-date version of Android. Such different strengths though, how do they stack up against one another? Looks-wise, with its soft-touch matte body and red accents, the HTC Desire C steals the show. It sits comfortably in the hand and pocket, and it feels more premium than its price suggests. The Samsung Galaxy Ace2 is considerably more bland. It's solid, but visually it lacks the flair of the Desire C, and its black plastic body and chrome-like accents make it look like all the other Galaxies on the market. Both phones offer exactly the same ports, with a 3.5mm headphone jack and a micro USB port, as well as removable batteries and a micro SD card slot. With its 800x480 WVGA LCD screen, the Samsung Galaxy Ace2, however, wins hands down when it comes to screen tech. With the Desire C only packing HVGA resolution, it's considerably less crisp. As we mentioned earlier, the HTC Desire C runs a newer version of Android, Android 4.0. It also has the latest version of HTC's interface, Sense, which is rammed with widgets and apps to get the most out of your mobile. The C therefore wins over the Samsung Galaxy Ace2 and its gingerbread, despite some nice UI tweaks. Edging it even further into victory is its keyboard, which is easier to use with great word prediction. The Ace2's 5-megapixel camera packs autofocus and a flash, whereas the 5-megapixel Desire C camera lacks both of these. The image quality reflects this, especially in close-up and nighttime shots. Video on the Ace2 is also shot at 720p, whereas the Desire C only records at VGA resolution and doesn't look so great when you export it to a screen. Connection-wise, both of these phones pack Wi-Fi, 3G and a GPS, though the HTC Desire C also boasts NFC. Thanks to Android 4.0, it supports Chrome web browser, which synchronizes seamlessly with its desktop counterparts. Having said that, thanks to the WVGA screen and dual-core processor of the Samsung Galaxy Ace2, it's quicker and it's easier to surf the web on, making it the overall winner in this round. The Samsung Galaxy Ace2 also wins in terms of performance thanks to its dual-core 800MHz processor. The Desire C's 600MHz processor, in contrast, is very outdated and won't cope with hardcore 3D games or heavy multitasking. When it comes to battery life though, it's pretty neck and neck, with about a day and a half from both these phones being a realistic expectation. So while the Desire C offers more charm and it wins out in terms of user interface, the Samsung Galaxy Ace2's speed and screen make it our winner.